Hey guys, SighBored here. Today we got a brand new helmet in front of us. We're going to do a quick unboxing of this HJC RPHA 11. It's the brand new one from HJC, top of the line. So before I unbox the helmet out from its box, let me just show you this label here. As you can see, there's this code here, and you can see the word NKS. So what this means is that this helmet is distributed by our official distributor here in Malaysia, which is going to be NKS. Now, what's the big deal being official distributed or not? Well, if you are getting a helmet from the official dealer, that means you are covered by the 5 years warranty, and also the helmet is registered to DPJ, so everything is all good and legal. If you're getting a helmet that is not from NKS distributor, that means it's probably from other countries like maybe Singapore or Thailand. So for that one, you're not actually covered by the 5 years warranty. So that's something to take note of. Price difference is not going to be that huge, so it's actually worth to consider. This helmet itself retails at $2179 before some minor discount available. That depends on your negotiation skills. So let's get the box open and see what we have inside right now. Immediately, what you have is the user manual. There's some couple of books here to teach you how to use the helmet, just in case you don't know. We have our helmet in its helmet bag. The helmet bag itself is looking pretty decent. You can actually use it to carry your helmet around. It's not some flimsy tin material. Pretty good. Next up, we have the dark visor. It comes together with the helmet, so you have the clear visor and the dark visor. And the last thing that we have here is going to be the pin lock, anti-fog pin lock insert. Comes ready with the helmet. You have some spare parts here, some buttons and pin lock post. So this is all you have inside the box when you purchase this RPHA 11. Let's have a quick look at the helmet right now to see what it looks like. Here we have the helmet finally out of its box, out of its helmet bag. This is going to be the RPHA 11 Rebirth MC1 SF model. It comes in a matte black finish. It has some red outlines for some color contrast. Looks pretty striking all around. Very nice paint job. I do like the design very much. It's very sleek. It's not too over the top, but definitely it has some design elements there. Fit and finish of the outer shell helmet, all looking pretty good. And the main difference coming from the RPHA 11 from the previous RPHA 10 Plus is going to be that this helmet shell is more compact. It's smaller than the previous generation, RPHA 10 Plus. However, in terms of the weight, it's actually going to be slightly heavier, maybe about 50 grams heavier, more or less. Now, let's look at the back of this helmet here. You should be able to see that there is a hologram sticker. And this sticker is only available if your helmet comes from the official local distributor in Malaysia. Otherwise, if you get your helmet from other sources, you probably won't have this hologram sticker on the helmet. Now, looking at the vents, we still have the two top vents like the previous model. However, the tab has been redesigned so that right now you have this rubber ring with a raised edge for you to feel. If you're wearing motorcycle gloves, you can still feel it. The tabs feel solid to move. It has its indentations, so you can rotate properly. What's new is going to be this front brow vent here, which the previous model didn't have. Very easy to find the tab. It's raised up a bit. This is for the front section of the helmet. It's a bit new look with a different extra front brow vent here. Looking at the visor, for the RPHA 11, the visor is actually slightly larger. You have a larger eye port for RPHA 11 compared to the 10 Plus. So that gives you more vision when you're wearing the helmet. The visor lock system is still having this tab to open and release. However, you see there's this extra black point here. This is to make it extra secure when you got the visor locked down to keep it from accidentally flying open. Looking at the chin vent section, the chin bar area here, the open ports here has also been slightly redesigned compared to the 10 Plus. The front tab here also the design is also much tapered down, sharper. This tab actually allows air to come into the front of your breath guard. As for the openings here, to open and close them, the tab is actually behind here, behind the chin bar. Okay, let me just turn it around and I'll show you how it looks like. Okay, so this is the chin vent for the front. It's the hidden tab at the back here. There's this slider you can open and close for airflow. Looking at the back of the helmet, in terms of venting, we have our always open exhaust ports at the back here. However, the spoiler now is covering over the open ports, unlike the previous model where it's just exposed, two dots on the top. So now it's hidden at the back. And apart from that, we have our side exhaust vents, always open as well, on both sides. So this is all for venting on the helmet. As you can see, in general, it looks like there's a lot of openings at the front of the helmet. So I'm expecting a high airflow when you're riding open with all the vents open. Alright guys, now looking at the interior of the helmet, the liner itself is having quite a good feeling. Compared to the previous 10 Plus, I would say that it is more or less comparable, maybe slightly more comfortable, but I wouldn't say it's like totally worlds apart. It's not a bad thing because the previous model was quite comfortable to begin with. What you see in front here is going to be the chin curtain. Now this chin curtain is fixed, it's no longer removable. Unlike the previous model where you had cases where the chin curtain tend to fall off or fly away while you are using it, or you can lose it. So no longer having that issue anymore with the chin curtain fixed. We have our two red lines here which are going to be the emergency release tabs. These are for use in case you need to open the helmet in case of emergency, a crash. They need to remove it without hurting the victim. The helmet is still sporting the double D-ring system. It's a tried and true system. Very secure, simple to use. So no big fuss over here. It has the tab here for you to lock up the extra leftover after you tighten up the chin strap. Alright, very simple and basic. No surprises here. So guys, let's a quick look at the RPHA 11. What I want to point out is that what's interesting from HJC is that apart from this new helmet lineup that they have, the RPHA 11 and so on, if you're not aware of it, HJC has actually partnered up with Marvel and they have a few of these Marvel themed helmets such as the Spider-Man, Venom, Iron Man helmets, pretty cool designs. And if I'm not mistaken, in the future there will be more to come, more characters such as, if I'm not mistaken, it's going to be like Deadpool, Ghost Rider, and even some Star Wars characters like Boba Fett and even Kylo Ren from Star Wars. So those are pretty cool things coming from HJC. Other than that, there is also this special one called the Monster Edition, where they actually have the Monster logos coming down on the side of the helmets. This is going to be something unique from HJC because prior to this, there hasn't been any other manufacturer, helmet manufacturer that is, that has any venture with Monster Energy to come up with specific helmets that have the Monster Energy logo. Not rider sponsored, not a replica, but having the Monster logos. So if you are a Monster fan, definitely keep an eye out for that. With that, let's end this video. Quick unboxing, I hope it was a quick one. I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. I'll be taking this helmet out to test ride it, to see how it feels. So till the next one guys, it's the Cyborg here. Ride safe, safe ride.